Hi, my name is Kaila Colbin. I'm with Singularity U New Zealand, and I'm here at Spark Lab to talk about exponentially accelerating technologies and what they mean for humanity. Singularity University is an organization based in Silicon Valley, dedicated to the study of these exponentially accelerating technologies, and specifically how they can be used to address humanity's biggest challenges. So in 1965, Gordon Moore, who was one of the co-founders of Intel, observed that the number of transistors we could fit on an integrated circuit had been doubling every 18 to 24 months or so, and he made a prediction it would continue to double as far forward as he can see. This became known as Moore's Law. It's really well known. One of the first insights from Singularity University is from Ray Kurzweil, one of the two co-founders. Kurzweil zoomed out on Moore's Law, and he said, actually, if instead of looking at the number of transistors we can fit on a circuit, we look at what we'd call the price performance of computing, how many million instructions per second can you buy for $1,000? That number has been doubling for over 100 years, starting with electromechanical punch cards, moving on to relays, vacuum tubes, transistors, then integrated circuits. Every time we max out on a particular technology, another one comes along to continue the doubling curve. And that doubling curve, that price performance curve, that's really what we're looking at across all of these different technologies. Most industries progress along what we call a linear progression. So this is where you get something like a car that goes slightly faster than the previous year's model, or is more fuel efficient than the previous year's model. So basically it's doing the same thing it's always done, but just a little bit better. And so you'll have something kind of going along this linear curve and something following a doubling curve. The doubling curve thing is super deceptive because it looks flat for so long. And then it hits that seventh or eighth fold of the paper, and it goes from kind of disillusionment up into chaos and amazement. And all of the incumbents who were just riding that linear progression held aloft by sustaining innovations, they're all completely taken by surprise and they go, it came out of the blue. How could anyone have known? So one of the other core insights from Singularity University is that not only are a whole range of technologies starting to hit that inflection point along the doubling curve where they go from disillusionment into chaos and amazement, they're also starting to converge. So now we have to consider what happens when an exponential progression in something like artificial intelligence converges with an exponential progression in big data, right? And what happens, of course, is that the technologies start to progress even faster, they build on each other, and the pace of change continues to accelerate. So the current projections are that somewhere between 47 and 81% of jobs as we currently understand them are under threat from technology within 20 years. And that sounds like a real fear-mongering number. So that does not factor in the new jobs that will be created from technology. And historically, every time we've had jobs that have been replaced by automation, that technology has enabled more new jobs than it has done away with. One of the things that's happening now is that we've never experienced this phenomenon of technological unemployment at this speed and at this scale. So we don't really know what to expect, and I think there's a reasonable likelihood that no matter what the outcome is, the transition will be messy. So those are things I think we need to be paying really close attention to, and they should be very front of mind for all of us, you know, not just for politicians who make policies and look at social welfare programs, but also for every one of us who has a job or ever wants to have a job. I'm Kaila Colbin, and I'm here at Spark Lab. I've had a fantastic evening, terrific talks, terrific people here. Come on down, get involved. Mm-hmm.